So today we are going to see image formation in the case of convex lens as well as in the case of concave lens. Okay, so you can see here we are having our convex lens. Okay, so from optical center we are going to measure focal length. This will be, we are going to measure focal length as well as 2f1. Okay, so here our optical center is, so I have taken 2 cm on both the sides. This is 2 cm, so this will be f1, here it will be f2. Then again from this f1, already I have told you that 2f2 will be twice of the focal length, so again 2 cm, this will be 2f1, and here we will have 2f2. So now let's see the first case. Okay, in the first case what will happen, object is kept at infinity. So we are assuming as if the object is kept at infinity. So all the light rays will be coming parallel. ये हमारा optical center है, ठीक है? So all the light rays from infinity, they will be coming parallel to the principal axis, and all these light rays after getting refracted, as they are parallel to principal axis, we have read in the rules that after getting refracted, it will be meeting at focus. So they will be meeting at focus. So you can see here, after getting refracted, all the light rays are meeting at focus. So image is produced at the focus on the other side of the mirror. So you can see here, V, that is object, will be produced on the other side of the mirror. That is, object is produced at F2, that is focus, which is present on the other side of the mirror. And the image produced here will be, nature of the image will be, as it is produced on the other side of the lens, so nature will be real and inverted. And size of the image, you can see here, the size is point size. So the size formed will be highly diminished, or it will be a point sized image that will be produced at F2 focus. Now moving on to the second case. Now in the second position, the object is kept beyond 2F1. Okay, so object is kept somewhere here beyond 2F1. So first ray will be coming parallel to the principal axis. So first ray from the object is parallel to the principal axis, and this ray after getting refracted, it will be passing through the focus of the, and it will be passing through F2 focus. Okay, after getting refracted, it will be passing through F2 focus. Now next rule states that ray from the object, it will be passing through optical center, so that ray, it will not deviate from its path, it will travel in a straight line. So here second ray that is passing from optical center, it will face no deviation. Okay, so you can see here it is moving straight, no deviation will be occurring. So no deviation will be occurring, and it will be traveling in a straight line. So that ray, both the refracted rays, they are meeting somewhere at this point. They are meeting somewhere at this point just before 2F2. So this is the position of image. Okay, object was kept beyond 2F1, and image of the object was produced just before 2F2. So now let's see the position. So object position was beyond 2F1, image was formed between F2 and 2F2. So it is formed between F2 and 2F2. Nature of position, as it is obtained on the opposite side, so nature will be real, and you can see that image is inverted, so it is real and inverted. Size, in comparison to the size of the object, you can see the image size is diminished. Okay, so we can write here, size of image is diminished. So this is the second case where object is kept beyond 2F. Now moving on to the third case, when object will be kept at 2F1. Object is present at 2F1, 1.5 0.5 centimeter height of the object present at 2F1. So first ray parallel to the principal axis, after getting refracted, it will be passing through the F2. Okay. Now second optical ray we will draw from optical center. Second ray of light from this image is passing through optical center and it will not be getting deviated anywhere. Here is our optical center. So you can see here, this is the second ray that is passing through the optical center. It is facing no deviation and it will meet at, so it is meeting at 2F2. Okay, so what is happening in the second case is when the position of object is at 2F1, the image is also produced at 2 but F2, okay, 2F2, that is image is produced on the opposite side where the object is kept. Nature of the image, as it is produced on the opposite side, so it is real. You can see here it is inverted, so it will be real and inverted, real and inverted. And size of the image is partially same in both the case, so size of the image will be same size of object. So this was the third case. Now moving on to the fourth case of image formation. In fourth case, image and object will be kept between 2F1 and 2F2. So let's see, between 2F1, so it is kept somewhere here. This is our object. Object is kept between 2F1 and 2F2. So first ray, same, parallel to principal axis. After getting refracted, passing through the principal focus present on the other side. So this is passing through principal focus. Second ray, passing through optical center. It will pass through optical center and no deviation will be occurring when it is passing through optical center. So you can see here both these rays are meeting somewhere at this point. Okay, and it is beyond 2F2. So when an object is kept between 2F1 and F1, when the position of object is between 2F1 and F1, as you can see here, image will be produced beyond 2F2. So image here is produced beyond 2F2. Nature of the image, as produced on the opposite side of the opposite side where object was kept, so it is real and inverted. And size of the image, clearly you can see size of the image is enlarged. It is enlarged. Okay, moving on to the next case where the object will be kept at F1. So this 1 centimeter object is kept at F1. First ray passing through first ray parallel to principal axis. After refraction, it will pass through focus, which is present on other side of the mirror. And second ray will be passing through optical center and without getting deviated, it will be passing straight. Okay, so this is the second ray. So you can see that both the rays are parallel, both the refracted rays are parallel. It means that they are not going to meet. So we assume that they will meet somewhere in the infinity. So when object position is at F1, as the object is present at F1, so in that case image position will also be, it will be at infinity. So image will be formed at infinity. Next, nature of image. So in that case nature of image will be real and inverted, as again it is forming on the opposite side of the mirror and below this principal axis, so it will be real and inverted. Moving on to the size of the image, in this case size of the image will be infinitely large, it will be highly enlarged. So here size of the image will be highly enlarged. Now moving on to the next case, we are assuming that the object is kept between F1 and optical center. So we are placing 1 centimeter size object between F1 and optical center. So let's see what will happen to the rays after getting refraction. So first ray parallel to the principal axis after getting refracted will be passing through the focus as always, okay. And second ray passing through optical center. यहाँ पे हम सिर्फ दो ही ray rules use कर रहे हैं, and with two rules we are drawing all the diagrams. So it is passing through optical center, and the ray is getting, no refraction is taking place. It is undeviated, no bending of the ray of light has taken place when it is passing through optical center. So you can see here on the other side the rays will never meet, but we assume that the rays are actually meeting on the side where the object is kept. That is, you can see when you extend these refracted rays backward with dotted lines, I am depicting the extended rays. So when we extend these dotted rays backward, we will see that they are meeting somewhere here between F1 and 2F1, right? So when object position is between F1 and optical center, image will be formed beyond F1. It will be formed beyond F1, okay. And the nature of image in this case, as you can see that image and object, they are kept on same side. So nature of image will be virtual in this case, and the size is, you can see the object is formed above the principal axis. So size will be erect. It is not inverted, it is erect. So image, nature of the image is virtual and erect. While size of the image, clearly you can figure out. This is the object size, this is the image size. So size of the object is again highly enlarged when the object is kept between F1 and O. All these are the cases in which image will be formed by the convex lens depending upon the various position of object. Now we are going to learn about image formation in the case of concave lenses. So we have only two cases in the case of convex lens. So let's see. Moving on to the image formation by concave lens. So here we have a concave lens. Let's draw principal axis and mark F1, 2F1, F2 and 2F2 on the principal axis. So this one is optical center. So with the help of scale, we are drawing a principal axis, and at 2 cm each, I am marking from the principal, from the optical center on the principal axis, I am marking F1. This will be our F1. This will be our 2F1. Here it will be our F2, and this will be 2F2. So F1, 2F2, here we have a 2F1, this is 2F1, here we have F2, and here we have 2F2. So let's see first case. Here we will only be dealing with two cases, okay. So first case is when the object is kept at infinity. So when the object is kept at infinity, all the light rays, they will be falling parallel to the principal axis, okay. So this is the optical center. So all the light rays, they will be coming parallel to the principal axis. So you can see here, these are the light rays which are parallel to the principal axis. And these light rays, after getting refracted, it will appear as if they are diverging from the principal focus, that is F1. So they will diverge out. After getting refracted, they will be diverging out, and it will appear as if they are diverging from the principal focus. So I am drawing a dotted extended ray backward, which is meeting at principal focus. So in this case, the refracted rays, extended refracted rays, they are meeting at F1. So image is formed on the same side as where object is kept. Now object position was at infinity, image position is at F1. Same jagah pe, object and image, they are formed on the same side of the lenses. Now moving on to the nature of image, as they are formed on the same side, so in the case of lenses, if the image and object they are produced on the same side, then the nature of image will be virtual. Okay, so here the nature of image will be virtual and it will be erect. So nature of image will be virtual and erect, and you can see clearly the size of the object is point size. Okay, so size of the object will be point size. Now moving on to the second case. In the second case, what will happen? The object will be kept somewhere between optical center and infinity. So the object will be present somewhere between optical center and infinity. In the second case, the object is kept between optical center and infinity. So let's keep the object here. Okay, suppose this 1 centimeter size object is kept here. So first light ray, they will be traveling parallel to the principal axis, and these light rays, after getting refracted, it will appear as if they are diverging from the principal focus. So here we have first light ray, incident light ray parallel to principal axis. So after getting refracted, it will appear as if they are diverging from principal focus. Okay, so this is the refracted ray and this is the extended part of the refracted ray. Now the second case is, second rule we will apply, and the light ray from the head of the object will be passing through optical center. So you can see here the light ray is passing through optical center, and this light ray, no refraction will be occurring as it is passing through optical center. So no deviation will take place. Now you can see that both the refracted rays are meeting somewhere at this point, and this point is between F1 and optical center. So clearly you can see that object image is getting formed between F1 and optical center. So we can say that whenever an object position is between infinity and optical center, image position will always be between F1 and optical center. What is the nature of the image? Both object and image are kept on same side, hence it is virtual. Then you can see it is produced above the principal axis, so it means it is erect. Then size of the image, clearly you can see 1 centimeter, less than 1 centimeter. The size of the image in this case will be diminished. Okay, so it will be diminished. So these are the two cases that will be produced in the case of concave mirror depending upon the position of object. So what we have seen is, concave mirror ke case mein, in the case of concave, sorry, not mirror, in the case of concave lenses, both the images are always virtual and they are erect. That is, they are formed on the same side where image and object are present. Next, in the case of convex lens, we get two types of images. First is, we get real and inverted images. So in all the cases except one, we are getting real and inverted image, and only in one case we are getting virtual and erect image. And that one case you can clearly see here, when the object is kept between F1 and optical center. So during that case, image produced in the case of convex lens will be a virtual and erect, while in all other cases it will always be real and inverted. Real and inverted means object will be kept somewhere here, an image will always be produced on the opposite side where the object is kept. Now in the next part of the chapter, we will be seeing sign conventions for spherical lenses, lens formula and its magnification, and power of the lenses.